After 8 years on the Upper East Side, Holiday House is rocking a new vibe in its Soho location. This year's show house at the Sullivan Mansions boasts an esteemed group of designers and a downtown sensibility. But one thing hasn't changed. All proceeds benefit the Breast Cancer Research Foundation, a cause that is near and dear to founder Iris Denker's heart. Come along and take a tour as we learn more. I'm Marissa Marcantonio, and this is Editor TV. We are here at Holiday House at the opening night, and Iris, you are being honored. Why is it so important for events like this to happen?
Well, because we have to raise money to get rid of such horrible scourges as breast cancer. And what better than to have a beautiful house on a lovely evening with a lot of talented designers, and people can come and make merry and help a worthy cause.
Such an amazing assortment this year. Did the location affect the designer choice this year? How did that come about?
Being downtown did affect what designers I chose, because I wanted designers that were cool, a little edgy, but I also think it was important that I had some of our, you know, as we call them, the A-list designers. But I also love, with the A-list designers, thinking out of the box and having some new emerging designers. I think that is great.
Have you had a chance to look around? What do you think?
I think it's amazing. I think it's a great idea. I think it's a great concept. I like that every room is so different, not particularly part of the one theme of a house. Everything is so different. You got Upper East Side, you got Upper West, you got Gramercy, you got Soho, you got Nolita. Everything all combined into one amazing house, and it's beautiful.
You have created such a fun space at Holiday House this year. Tell us about it.
It's Black Friday. But we took Black Friday and then we made it super elegant, as you can see from all the materials. We have Alcantara fabric on the wall here, and some kind of commerce-driven art that's the background to our dining room. We've got beautiful black crows adorning the center of our table. You always have to bring a level of comedy.
Absolutely. Something extra.
Comedy with beauty.
So my room is rosé all day. My mother passed away of cancer, and throughout her whole illness, it was my creativity and all the beautiful things I did in her home that kept her living on, and I really feel it's about living life and enjoying all these beautiful things and creating an ambiance.
The first thing I noticed when I walked in the room was how scent can impact a space, and I know that that doesn't come across on the camera, but Tell us about the senses and how they affect design in your room.
Design is about sensory, you know, no matter what we're talking about, fashion, interiors, it's about how you look and feel and touch and smell, and it really is all those senses coming together. I think that makes for a really impactful, great experience. You know, so I've got clementines on the floor, and it's about food and taste and all of it coming together.
Being amongst all of these designers here supporting this great cause, what is that like for you?
Oh, it was great. There was like a real big like team spirit. Made new friends, met old friends, and you know, that's what we do. We have to keep on spreading love and spreading positive energy. That's what we need to do.
As you go through the house, do you have any favorite moments or rooms or ideas that are jumping out at you?
I think there's a lot of boldness here. A lot of people doing things that they might not necessarily do if they were doing them for clients, but because they're doing them for the benefit of breast cancer research, it's really beautiful.
Designers have curated vintage and antique finds from InCollect. How did it all work?
It was a bit hectic, but it worked out really well. So someone, for example, Tori, who has this beautiful room, Tori literally went on InCollect, found what she liked, either emailed or picked up the phone and called the dealers and said, I'm putting this great room together for Holiday House. And within a couple days, she had it all put together.
Do you have a favorite space?
Oh, Harry Heisman, by all means, the black and white room.
The magician.
I love it. Even the black and white cookie, it's free.
Black and white Christmas is his theme, and he had so much fun with it, right?
Fantastic.
Tell us how the connection with Holiday House came about.
So actually, it's Jared Seligman, who works for Douglas Elliman, which represents the developer that's selling the tower and the townhouses. He just had an inspiration, I think, over the summer to introduce me to Iris Denker. She didn't believe that I'd have the townhouses finished in time for her event, but we worked hard and we got it done.
So as you were working on this, what makes it stand out from other historic properties?
The ceilings are high. The elliptical stair is really a feature which you find in old McKim, Mead & White. buildings, you know, which were done at the turn of the century. It's very special, and just the sequence of how you move through the space is incredibly exciting.
Tell us about the piece of art that you have here at Holiday House.
Well, the painting I did was of Iris, and if I could do anything to help breast cancer charity research through Holiday House, I'm always happy to do it. I love Holiday House.
Thanks for joining us at the opening celebration for Holiday House. The show house is open till January 8th, so we hope you'll come check it out. I'm Marissa Marcantonio, and you're watching Editor TV. See you next time.